and can we close them? Then you have to close that gap between what was sanctioned and what is disbursed. I want very much to assure you all that as far as the government is concerned, we will support them in recoveries and action against defaulters. That's another area that we need to sit down and talk about and then decide how we're going to go about it. But we will be there to support you in any way, every way that we need to, because we understand that that is the area which will go further to help more people in time to come. Now, even as I speak, I'm just coming back to Jhalawar. There are pockets which are still not under the formal banking network. I give you the example of Manohar Thana, which is part of Jhalawar. It's actually an M&A constituency. It could do with more bank branches. The people are absolutely desperate. Then it's important that you expand the banking correspondent network and that the BCs get sensitized to conduct themselves with a sense of responsibility and sensitivity so that there's no aspersions cast. Because it's very easy. And it's not pointing fingers at each other and the good work goes down the tube. We don't want it because as government, it is very important for us that everybody keeps their nose above that water so that all the good work that we are doing and that the Prime Minister is engineering for us to do, that in no way impairs our further movement. Then, in order to enhance accessibility now to the banking services in very far off areas, and also to realize this vision of the digital payment, we are going to provide some 20,000 micro ATMs and tablets from the state funds. So I'm asking that we should take on board additional business correspondents, especially below the panchayat level, as fast as we possibly can. Then, core banking and e-enablement. When you look at it, you just see how wonderfully transparent and easy banking services can actually become. But we need to bring that transparency into lending. A farmer deserves to know the status of his loan application all through the stages of processing through an SMS. Why shouldn't he? What is there to hide? Why shouldn't he? Because now we are talking transparency. We are talking transparency. It can't be one-sided. So we need to work to see how we can do this. We have to see and be sensitive to the fact that in absence of timely credit, he will have to borrow from at very, very unhealthy terms from moneylenders. Then, non-availability of cash. This is another hassle. And it's something that is affecting us all, but has really a much more serious impact on those people who are living in the rural areas. So we need to please, I would like to ask you to please, if it's possible, to go that extra mile to see that this is insured at every branch. And these ATM and banking correspondents, all of these people have the sufficient cash in small denominations so that the households don't have to suffer. I'm sure this is going to get easier as the time comes by because certain amount of transactions all go digital, but a certain amount of transaction will still be through small, denominations. Because it happens in every country. So that will settle shortly, but till that happens, we need to be able to be supportive about this. Another interesting one is the corporate social responsibility. I think that the banks can actually do amazing things with the CSR in the Rural Development and Self-Employment Training Institutes, which is the Youth City model. And it's proven to be a great success, and I'm seeing it as it goes across Rajasthan. But the time is ripe to see whether we can actually involve them like PNB has done just now. In Skill India, can you shake hands with Youth City, Skill India, Digital India, Make in India, can all these come together? And It's okay, all of you maintain your traffic islands and all your little gardens and put your little placard in front of it, maintained by whichever bank it is. But I think we really need to move on now from just those round circles and gardens. Don't you agree? And I think that that's quite okay, because I mean, you've salved your conscience for the CSR by doing that little garden. And I'm saying, let's not do just that. Can we salve our conscience by actually using the CSR for something like these road cities? And actually, as I said, shaking hands with all the others. So, I think we would be able to benefit from your CSR much, much more if we can actually put our money on the investment in human resource development. And that is really very, very important, because for India today to move into that league that we're talking about, Brandis is talking about, then there's only one way, and that way is to see that every person, and each of us has that responsibility to see that every person we can get our hands on is skilled and ready to pick up something where he can further go out and help someone else. That's the only way. It will go in a chain reaction, one to another, and this, I think, will make the difference. Meanwhile, I would just like to say that as far as the government is concerned, for development of the industry and construction of homes, there's been a lowering of the stamp duty. Maximum limit has gone from 10 lakhs to 5 lakhs, so that we can give a loan at an economic rate. Then the Bahamasha Rozgar Srijan Yojana for the unemployed youth. We are giving 5 to 10 lakhs to uneducated, unemployed women and scheduled tribes, physically handicapped people, 4% interest subsidy. And in our state budget just now, we have also announced an interest subvention to good loany farmers amounting to about 370 crores. We've also decided to give 150 crores to cooperative banks to compensate the losses due to high cost of funds involved in this low-cost, short-term lending business. Then, now most of you are working with us in the path-breaking Bahamasha scheme, and there's a 26 lakh rupee Kisan debit cards which we are going to be issuing soon to the KCC holders of the cooperative banks. And this will allow the farmers to draw money from all the ATMs. This is what government is doing. Meanwhile, I would like to convey my deepest appreciation, that I will want to do, to all of you for the proactive support that is actually being given to us all by you all. And I'm sure that that dream that we talked about, making Rajasthan a vibrant state, is something that we will be able to do by actually creating industrial development and also by creating job opportunities for the young people. And for this, I think we both need to work together to create a hassle-free lending scenario, and also trying to lend on a slightly larger scale so that we can actually harness the potential of those entrepreneurs, and also can we get hold of good mineral and agricultural resources and use them well for the state. So these are some of the, and while we were talking about it, I checked with Akhil. You spoke, aapne baat ki thi about how to be able to extend increasing viability and connectivity, basically. So rent-free space in Atal Seva Kendras up to the Panchayat. Connectivity on Raj network at minimal cost. There are only 131 villages now in Rajasthan without the proper connectivity, and 25,000 villages, even the POS is being at the moment, it works. And I think, Akhil, you also used VSAT, we've also used aerials. I mean, Rajasthan, because we've been working on this for a long time, you'll find that you'll be able to reach across the state. There are very few places which, and if you complain, they would be able to take care of it pretty much quickly. Now, if you did, we'd be happy, there's no hassle. If you did, we'd be able to improve it. because they are on the job all the time. We are not complaining about that. We say, if you did tell us about it, we'd be happy to know, because we have such few left in Rajasthan, that those few also we would like to take on board and work. If somebody tells us, ki yahan thoda sa problem ho raha hai, we'll do our best to make it much better. Because we would like to be one of the first states which you can reach comfortably across, being the largest state in the country, and then to have this kind of connectivity is not a joke. So it's obviously hard work by the officers of the state of Rajasthan, and they've been really working in the last 4 years plus that one and a half years to see that this connectivity gets across the state, and that all of those people who want to use our platforms can do so comfortably. 20,000 tablets I told you about, additional VCs. You don't require a fixed monthly retainership, only for, as he calls it, transaction charges. And there's an additional 10 rupees per transaction on the DBT under Bhamasha for banks and DSPs. Yes. But otherwise, I think we are pretty much on board with you. If we are able to tailor-make these SLBCs for even better results, you could do it as a pilot project with us in Rajasthan, and the next time you're in Delhi, you could present it to the Prime Minister as a project that you have done, where every single one of your districts are working together with your SLBCs to see that maximum benefits go down to the people. I think that this is not a complaint in any fashion. I just believe that we can just make it better. And so we need to take it in a good light. I want all of you to understand, we're not complaining about you. All I'm trying to say is that there's a dream to fulfill. There's a vision before us. And if this vision and dream has to be fulfilled, then we have to think out of the box. Rajasthan's been doing a little bit of that thinking, and we would be very happy if you met us halfway. And we could present 33 districts of Rajasthan in which we have been able to make that difference. So I want to thank you very, very much for all of you being here with us today. And one thing, sir, Sarita ji, I will want to bring to your notice. आपने कहा बीकानेर के अंदर और आपने झालावाड़ में SHGs ली हैं, एंड यू आर नाउ वांटिंग टू स्ट्रेंथन दोज SHGs. आई वुड लाइक यू टू प्लीज लुक एट द SHG मूवमेंट इन धौलपुर डिस्ट्रिक्ट, विच एक्चुअली इज वेयर आई एम फ्रॉम, बट इवन आई हैव पेड अटेंशन. दिस टाइम व्हेन आई वाज देयर, मिस्टर अभय कुमार इंट्रोड्यूस मी टू, एंड आई वॉज एब्सोल्युटली ब्लोन अवे बाय द काइंड ऑफ वर्क दैट दे हैव डन. देयर आर 52,000 वुमेन working under SHGs that have federated, 17,000 of them, with a 40 crore, correct me if I'm wrong, with a 40 crore saving. Google has called some of those SHGs to teach other SHGs as to how they have taught themselves to work on those. It's absolutely incredible what those women have done. World Bank has called them and worked with them to see how they have worked, and are sending them to places like Africa to teach them. And we have them sitting over here, and I was just telling our officers, I said, we are calling people from Andhra Pradesh, we are calling people from Telangana, why are we doing that? We've got 52,000 women here who can do everything and more. And they are bright as buttons, they come from villages where half their life there was no schools. From where they to get to the district headquarters is a problem. Yes, they are bright, smiling, confident, and able to get you a saving of 40 crores. And every one of their loans have been paid back on time. Tell me, there is something missing there. They are amazing. These are the kind of people that we have to pick up, support, strengthen, and send out to other districts. So your SHG movement will do very well by using this. And finally, I'd like to say, thank you very much, Jana sir, for all the complimentary things you said about Rajasthan and the workings of Rajasthan. I really appreciate having you here with us today, you and Sarita ji and all the team, and it's really been a pleasure to have you all. I think the icing on the cake would be, all of you took time today, half an hour, whatever time you have, where you race off to all the other important businesses that you all have. But if you can take half an hour out and just visit Gram, those of you who haven't done it, just drop into the Jajans. Just see the kind of excitement there is and this Gram has generated. I would just like you to understand, when you see that, and this is not Jaipur, this is district Kota, Jhalawar, Bara and Bundi, only four districts. And there in Jaipur, 58,000 farmers who visited in 2 days now. Kitne ho gaye aapke? Now, we didn't want to do more than 30. But they are coming at the rate of 15 to 18 every day. So we are going to hit a much higher mark than we did even in Jaipur. The excitement, the curiosity, and the interest that we found here is amazing, unusual, and maybe not so unusual because everyone wants to better their life. I would like you all to just go take a look so that you can understand what it is, what are the aspirations of the people that we have to match, and why it is that we have to match. So I'll be very grateful if you will take a little bit of time and visit. And aap kisi ko laga doge iske sath jo bhi jana chahte hain, is tarah agar aap laga doge ghuma doge ek dafa, to main samajhti hu ki unko samajh mein aayegi ki kya hai karan jiske liye hame wo vision ko pura karna hai. Kyunki log ab uske liye aatur hain, log apni zindagi ko behtar banana chahte hain, uske liye aapki madad ki zarurat hogi. Please have a look and you will see why and what I mean. Thank you all very very much for being so patient, and thank you very much for the amazing work that all of you are doing to work with us in Rajasthan. Thank you. I look forward to seeing you in the various districts, and maybe if you're going to do this, then the SLBC will might find that I've run up to just to hear what's going on. Thank you all very much.
Tum sabhi bank
aur सबसे वैल्यूबल हमारे इन्वेस्टर्स एंड ऑफकोर्स मैं सबको कहती हूं कि वैल्यू कितना है वो इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है, परंतु आप लाए सेटअप करने की हिम्मत रही और मुझे विश्वास है कि वो सक्सेसफुली आप सेटअप करोगे, चाहे वो 10 करोड़ का है चाहे वो 100 करोड़ का है, हमारे लिए आप उतनी वैल्यूबल हो जितने अगर वो 1000 करोड़ का लगा रहा है. मुझे बहुत खुशी है आज आपको ग्राम में वेलकम करते हुए. जयपुर का एडिशन हो गया, परंतु कोटा का एडिशन जो यहाँ हुआ है वो मैं मानती हूँ कि हमको प्रभुराज को सबसे ज्यादा सेटिस्फैक्शन दिया. एक आप लोग सबसे मौका मिलने का, और दूसरा इतनी बड़ी संख्या में हमारे किसानों का यहाँ आने का. और आप ये देख लेंगे कि बड़ी जगह में किसान आए तो सही, परंतु वो कैपिटल है राजस्थान का जयपुर, तो कोटा जैसी जगह में जहाँ चार डिस्ट्रिक्ट हैं वहाँ एवरी डे करीबन 15 से 16 हजार आदमी आ रहा है. और हम मानते हैं कि जो हमने सोचा था कि 30,000 आदमी आएंगे पूरे 3 दिन के अंदर, उससे कई ज्यादा लोग यहाँ होके जाएंगे. और सबसे बड़ी बात है कि किसान अपने पैर पे खड़ा होना चाहता है, नवाचार को सीखना चाहता है, न्यू टेक्निक्स को समझना चाहता है, एंड एक एस्पिरेशनली अपवर्डली मोबाइल बनने का. यहाँ जो आदमी आ रहा है वो ये चाहता है कि मैंने अभी जो कर लिया उससे 10 दफा आगे मैं बढ़ूं, और हम उसको इनकरेज करना चाहते हैं. आज हमारे बैंकर्स की भी मीटिंग हुई, आप लोग भी यहाँ हों, इतने सारे किसान आए, इतने सारे विशेषज्ञ आए, इतनी सारी जाजम बैठकें हुई जिनके अंदर इन लोगों को डिस्कस करने का मौका मिला, इतने अच्छे विशेषज्ञों के राउंड टेबल्स हुए जिसके अंदर मंत्रियों ने भी अपनी बात रखी और विशेषज्ञों ने भी अपनी अपनी बातें रखी. और मैं समझती हूँ कि उसके अंदर इंथुजियास्टिक पार्टिसिपेशन हुआ हमारे फार्मर्स का, यही सबसे बड़ी बात. हम मानते हैं कि राजस्थान का 65 से 70% आदमी किसान है, और इसलिए हमको उसको किस तरीके से मजबूत करना है लोग मानते हैं कि डेजर्ट रीजन के अंदर क्या किसान काम करेगा, परंतु मैं ये जानती हूँ कि डेजर्ट रीजन ही अकेला नहीं है, राजस्थान का फैला हुआ क्षेत्र जरूर है पर अलग अलग किस्म के क्लाइमेट जोन इस क्षेत्र के अंदर है। और बहुत सारे लोगों आप जैसे ने इन अलग अलग जोन का पूरा पूरा यूज करने का मन बना के यहाँ आके अपनी छोटी इंडस्ट्री, अपनी बड़ी इंडस्ट्री, अपनी मध्यम इंडस्ट्री लगाने का काम किया है। और जो एक एक व्यक्ति अपनी इंडस्ट्री यहाँ चला रहा है उसकी वजह से कई उधर क्षेत्र के लोगों को काम भी मिलेगा, उनको नई बात सीखने को मिलेगा और आने वाले समय के अंदर एक लेवल ऑफ एजुकेशन भी उसमें पड़ेगा, क्योंकि जब आदमी देखता है तो उसको और समझने की वो लगती है कि मैं इसको और समझूं, इसके बारे में मैं और अच्छा काम करने की कोशिश करूं, तो उसका फायदा उस क्षेत्र के अंदर के लोगों को मिलता है। मैं समझती हूं कि अपने आप में ही ये एक बहुत बड़ी बात है। ये आज जो यहाँ आप लोगों के MOUs हुए हैं, मस्टर्ड ऑयल एक्सपेंडिंग एंड सॉल्वेंट एक्सट्रैक्शन, सोया मस्टर्ड रिफाइंड ऑयल, ब्लैंड सोया प्रोटीन कॉन्सेंट्रेट, फाइबर फूड क्लस्टर फॉर पल्सेस, कैश्यू प्रोसेसिंग, आई एम वेरी इंटरेस्टेड। आप कहा सीकर में कर रहे हो? सीकर में वेर यू ब्रिंगिंग द काजू फ्रॉम? दैट्स व्हाई योर बिजनेस मैन एंड वी कांट अंडरस्टैंड। पैसा बनाना आसान नहीं है।
सक्सेसफुल हो सकती है यहाँ भी, हम चाहते हैं कि राजस्थान हब बने और यहाँ पर भी यूनिट्स आए।
इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग एंड वी विल बी ऑल लुकिंग एट टू सी हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू मेक दिस सक्सेसफुल विथ ऑल आवर प्रेयर्स। आई वॉन्ट एवरी वन टू लुक एंड सी कि भैया ऐसा जरूरी नहीं जैसे आप कह रहे हो, जहाँ का प्रोड्यूसर है वहीं आपको करने की जरूरत होगी। आपने एक अनूठा प्रयास किया है, उस प्रयास में आई एम श्योर यू विल बी ह्यूजली सक्सेसफुल। इंटीग्रेटेड कोल्ड चेन तो आप ही लोग कर रहे हो, मुझे अच्छा लगा आप लोगों को देख के। आप घर परिवार के ही लोग हो, ओम प्रकाश जी और अभिलाष जी का बहुत मना मैंने उनका एक धौलपुर के लिए बहुत सारे काम उन्होंने किए हैं, आई रियली अप्रिशिएट दैट। आप उनके पदचिन्हों में चल रहे हो, थैंक यू वेरी मच। ये इट इज द नीड ऑफ द आवर कोल्ड चेन्स एंड आई एम लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू डूइंग गुड बिजनेस विद यू। देन प्राइवेट सब मार्केट यार्ड्स, प्राइवेट मंडी यार्ड्स एंड एग्रो प्रोसेसिंग यूनिट्स। प्रभुलाल जी ने अभी आपको बताया एग्रो प्रोसेसिंग यूनिट्स अगर होते हैं उस किसान के खेत में होते हैं तो और भी, और उसको इतनी छूट भी दे दी गई है, सब्सिडाइज भी किया गया है। मैं समझती हूँ कि और भी जगह के अंदर आपको देखते हैं कि वो लोग भी काम करना शुरू कर दें। लॉजिस्टिक पार्क्स, प्रोसेसिंग फैसिलिटीज, डेयरी, दिस वन आई एम लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू। हाँ गया डेयरी वाले, दिस वन आई एम लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू। यू टोल्ड मी दैट यू ऑलरेडी फिनिश्ड द टी, ऑलिव टी, नाउ यू आर स्टार्टिंग विद द जूसेस एंड यू से दैट बाय जून नेक्स्ट ईयर 1000 गाय हो जाएगी, 250 का फर्स्ट। बड़ी हिम्मत है, जानवरों को संभालना कोई आसान काम नहीं है।
250 जो काउज है वो पूरे इंडियन में ग्रेट है।
चौधरी है चौधरी, चलो ठीक है, काम तो कर ही लेगा। तो नहीं हुआ है, इसका लाभ हमारे युवाओं को भी होगा, महिलाओं को भी होगा, क्योंकि उन लोगों को सबको रोजगार मिलेगा। और आपका प्रत्यक्ष रूप से तो अपन ने गिनती कर ली, परंतु अप्रत्यक्ष रूप से हमने भी गिनती की थी। मैं समझती हूँ 18 से 20 हजार लोगों को अप्रत्यक्ष रूप से भी आपको नौकरी देने का, रोजगार देने का एक अच्छा काम दोगे। वेंकैया जी कल एवरग्रीन एवरग्रीन की बात कर रहे थे, मुझे नहीं मालूम आप लोगों में से पूछते हैं कि नहीं। दिस एवरग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन को इसी तरीके से हम लोगों को चालू करना है। आई एम श्योर दैट विथ ऑल दोज आईज दैट यू टॉक्ड अबाउट, उनका फायदा हम लोगों को मिलेगा। और MOUs को धरातल के अंदर लाने का मैंने जोर तो हमेशा लगता ही है, परंतु हम चाहेंगे कि जल्दी से जल्दी ये काम आप लोगों का हो जाएगा तो किसान भाई भी आपके साथ इसका लाभ उठा सके। स्मार्ट फार्म और एग्जीबिशन का आई होप आप लोगों ने भ्रमण किया है, क्या है घूमे ना, और आपने जाजम बैठक को भी देखा होगा। यह अपने आप में अनूठा प्रयास है और किसान उसमें कितना इंटरेस्ट ले रहे हैं वो भी आपने देखा होगा। आई एम रियली रियली वेरी प्राउड एंड प्लीज, क्योंकि मुझे ये लगता है कि अगर अपने खेतों में ये सब चीजों को इस्तेमाल करेंगे तो राजस्थान में एक समृद्धि फैलेगी इनकी वजह से और आप लोगों की वजह से। सो आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू राजस्थान एंड आई होप आने वाले समय के अंदर आप अपने अपने यूनिट्स को जल्दी जल्दी खड़ा कर देंगे। वी होप एंड आई रियली थिंक दैट यू शुड टॉक टू ऑल द कलेक्टर्स नाउ, इट शुड नॉट बी जस्ट डायरेक्टेड टू जयपुर, इट शुड बी कनेक्टेड टू द कलेक्टर्स एंड यू शुड टेल द कलेक्टर्स दैट दीज आर योर बिजनेसेस, प्लीज हैव अ लुक एट दीज एंड दे शुड गेट इन टच विद दोस द बिजनेस इटसेल्फ एंड देन चेस इट अप सो दैट इट बिकम्स अ सिंगल विंडो क्लियरेंस फॉर देम। आई थिंक दैट विल मेक forward to seeing you up and about and working. Maybe I get a chance to visit some of your units while this is on. I look forward to seeing you. Jalawar mein, so yours I will take care of. I've heard about your uphill journey. I hope to be able to bring that to a level playing field, and so you should not be worried about it. And I'm taking particular interest because you happen to be the only one out of these gentlemen here who are trekking to Jalawar.
I would like to actually thank you. I noticed that in the earlier draft 2016 we have done an MOU.
I know, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, ma'am, we have implemented everything and we are on the commissioning stage. We are just waiting for the license to be come up and then we can come into the
project. Has told me about it, yes. And because I took an interest because I said who is this person who is going to Jalawar, so he told me your story.
Yes.
And that's the only reason I'm going to take interest in it.
Thank you.
So I will smooth out your uphill journey, hopefully. It will become a smooth and straight journey for you to get straight into Jalawar and get on with your business.
Yep.
Okay?
Thank you
all very, very much. I look forward to seeing you up and about soon. Kabulal ji, this is the second day. Kal Jalawar hoke aaj aa rahi hu wapas. But I think in front of all of you, I must congratulate the department. Nitin ji, we can't go from one gram to another. Because we have to do more grams. So, issue is, congratulations, because this gram, every gram I think is better than the last one. You have learned from the whatever small mistakes you may have made, and you've taken it to another level. And I'm thinking that each of these grams is going to get better still. So, well done. Of course, without your minister's guidance and total interest, you all wouldn't have got where you have, so I must congratulate Kamalaji along with all of you. Just keep up the good work. And to all four collectors who are sending their people, and to Collector Kota, who is the model agency here, I hope all of it goes well. To the UITs, to the mayor, all of you, please continue to keep Kota clean. And again, a huge congratulations for the success of this draft. Thank you. Our Minister for Agriculture, Mr. Mehra, Principal Secretary of Finance, Mr. Jena, Chief General Manager of RBI, Sarita Ji, Chief General Manager of NABARD, the officers of the Government of Rajasthan, and all the ranking fraternity present here. First of all, I want to thank you all very, very much, because I think this was at short notice and yet we were able to collect all of you here for this meeting. I really appreciate that and thank you very much for it. Rajasthan, as is the Prime Minister's idea for the whole of the country, we also are wanting to take our place in the Committee of States of this country. And therefore for us it's very important that every one of those of us who are working together for the benefit of the state pull our weight. There was a time when the bankers belonged in a different stratosphere. Everybody else was in a different stratosphere and never the twain met. Or they met at formal SLBC meetings and they formally made their comments and everybody left. Today, the dream that and the roadmap that the Prime Minister has set out for this country now makes things very, very different. And it's absolutely imperative that we get off the floor and move upwards, and you get out of the stratosphere and move downwards. And somewhere along the line we meet. We demystify the workings of the banks so that ordinary people also are able to understand them and take advantage fully of what the banks ought to mean to the people. So today I asked PSLF, I said it would be very nice because we are having gram. There are a lot of farmers going to be coming here today. We want you to see the atmosphere. We want you to see how upwardly mobile these people are and what aspirations they all have. And we want you to understand that if we have to put that dream on the ground, then we all have to put our weight behind it. So this is one of the reasons why it was important that we meet, and I'm just going to ask you all, and I'm sure you have the SLBC meetings where everyone makes their reports and makes PowerPoint presentations and goes home. I think it would be a very good idea to surprise one or two or three districts by picking up those people at that particular moment in time, putting them together with the collector of that area, that meeting, and getting them to tell us what is it that the collector is finding them wanting in and how they are going to meet that. Because figures to talk is very easy. You give them a figure, a rounded figure of so much lending, so much branches, so much this, so much, is very interesting. But the district needs to be there, and so I'll ask PSF, and you make a surprise, are you, all your bankers are there at that. Just let the PSF pull two out of a hat. Bring those two there, because if everyone is capable and on top of it all, then the problems that the district is facing would already have been either taken care of by them or he's capable of taking care of it. But at this moment in time, we are not meeting. We are meeting. And we will be able to solve a few problems at our level. But what we need to do is to actually create that connect between them and the district, while we sit before them to see what exactly it is that the district wanted and where it is that the bank meets them. Now, there are some progressive measures that every state takes, and then in that sense Rajasthan has taken them also. And I'm sure that a lot of those measures have come up before you. There's no need for me to go deep into all of these, but then there's Bhamasha Swasthima, there's so many others. For example, just now, Mr. Agarwal had just spoken to you about the MSMEs. Having been the Minister for MSME at one point in time, and also having dealt with SIDBI very, very closely, and having created the credit guarantee at that particular moment in time, I am sometimes very surprised at why it is that we are not. We talk about the MSME when the banker sits. The MSMEs, if you take them aside, will cry blue when they are separate. Why is it that we don't have a meeting where the SLBCs meet, or particularly only for the MSMEs? They have a lot of problems, and whether we like it or not, they are the base structure of our economy. I don't have the figures just now, but when I was minister, I remember we were talking about chasing NPAs of 70,000 with big industry. Whereas MSMEs for the whole of the country was that one big industry. 70,000 crores NPAs, huge NPAs. And throwing good money after bad, while at that moment in time, your NPAs of the small industries were not more than 10,000 crores. Now they've gone up, and they will continue to go up, because if you put a stitch in time, those are the ones, because they're used to standing on their own feet, they're used to having to struggle, they they don't complain that much. And if you're able to put them on the ground and put those two, three stitches in on time, we will be perhaps able to avoid that problem that we see now looming ahead of us. Because I was just checking the other day and they tell me 10,000 crores was then, and that was 10, 15 years ago. Let's say 2002, 2003. But now if you come down the line, we're already 14 years down from there, I'm sure those NPAs have gone up. Just from the state point of view, I'm going to give you just one or two examples, but I think that if you agree to this method of working, then everybody will have to bone up on their structures before they come to the meeting. Because they could be chosen, they couldn't be chosen, they didn't necessarily be chosen. But they need to be ready about their district or districts. And the collector at that point in time will talk about what difficulties he's having there or what good things that bank has done there. For example, I'm just giving it to you now. I mean, it's an example that no one has to get hurt about it or feel bad about it. It's an example. I want to take it in that light. But I can just tell you that when the state was actually crafting its scheme for financial inclusion and direct benefit transfer in 2005, my name was 2006-07, just before the, about a year before the election. At that point in time, it was not in fashion. And I remember very, very clearly, no bank wanted to touch us or work with us for that so-called now very fashionable scheme called financial inclusion. Nobody wanted to touch us. Everybody told us, how do you get those cards? That plastic is not available here. I mean, these were the difficulties we came across. I don't think anybody is going to say today the plastic is not available. But that is what we went through. I'm sure all of you remember that. But we had only one bank at that point in time that actually said, okay, I'm prepared to take that risk and worked with us where no one was willing to touch us. So I'm grateful for that. And I'm also wanting to say that that's possible if all bankers looked out, looked forward. You would have known that this was going to be the scheme of the future and that Rajasthan was a great place to do a pilot in when tomorrow the government of India took it up as it did in 2009-10 with Aadhaar and then moved forward in the next few years. It's the scheme that has the flavor of the century. But no bank wanted to work with us there. So it's very important that today I think Rajasthan has the first DBT financial inclusion scheme that the country offered with Bhamashah. We already have more than 4.5 crore families involved in this. It's 1.38 crore families and about 4.5 crore people, individuals, that are involved with this. And there's no pain. You don't hear about it anywhere. People are now on POS machines, they are on swiping their cards, we are already in sync with the buffet. There are how many e-mitras? 40,000 e-mitras. How many Atal Seva Kendras? 10,000 Atal Seva Kendras. I would imagine that 25% of the country's Atal Seva and e-mitras belong to Rajasthan. And you don't hear a noise. Everybody is doing their work very quietly. Everybody progressed very quietly. They've learned how to use their cards. All this is happening. All I'm asking is, why is it not a good idea to actually extend oneself, to think beyond what we already have? One of you had taken that. And today, as I'm saying to you, everyone's firing off the RCT shoulder. Very interesting. But that time, with this particular bank, we worked in Bay Road. It was before I demitted office in that last time. And we set up an RCT then. That was 2007-8. And that was something in its own self. Now today, I went to open the PNB's RCT, which I think is an unusual one. Maybe not, probably one of the first few, at least in Rajasthan, where they're now not just doing the RCT where the tractors and other services and computers and all are there, but they've also gone beyond the pale and actually working with farmers in the fields. and also working to skill those people in that particular line. I'm very, very pleased with that. So it's the new things. We don't do the RCET because we have to do it. We don't do skill because we have to do it. We think out of the box because that is going to serve the people, which is our motto, right? Am I right? If that's the motto, why are we shackle bound? Why can we not break those shackles? Why are we only thinking about my payback and payouts? Why is it that we don't think that our paybacks and payouts would do better if we thought out of the box? For example, I'm just giving you some. I have two. Before I say thank you to all of you, I'm going to say the bad things, then I will say the good things. And then I've seen the good things too. Mudra, for example. I think it's a great facilitator for creating employment for these unemployed youth. The target set on the scheme, I believe, is a little on the lower side. And the feedback that I got in my travels through the districts is that cloning is not made available in many instances, forcing those people to go for their working capital loans to alternative sources which are giving it to them at much, much higher rates. So, I can only say that maybe we should set a higher target for lending, and also the quantum of the loan should be appropriate so that it caters for that particular need of that person. We are not khanapurti nahi kar rahe. हमको लोन देना है मुद्रा के नीचे तो आप ठीक है खाना पूर्ति हमने तो लोन दे दिया अब क्या लोन दिया उसने किस बिजनेस के लिए मांगा उसने कितना मांगा और आपने क्या दिया क्या वो उस लोन को कवर कर रहा है पर नहीं तो फिर मतलब क्या रहा आई गिव यू वन इंस्टेंस फॉर एग्जाम्पल इट हैज कम टू आवर नॉलेज दैट सम बैंक्स हैव डायरेक्टली डिडक्टेड फ्रॉम द ग्रांट्स और इंस्टॉलमेंट्स given under PM Awas Yojana to recover old dues. The Panchayati Raj and rural development people have just brought this to our notice. I think it's horrible. On one side you're supposed to be giving subsidies, fulfilling the Prime Minister's dream, and on the other side you're actually taking that subsidy and cutting it out. It's very difficult to come to terms with. So then, I mean, that direct benefit transfer of the social security measures doesn't fulfill its promise. I'd much rather not give a DBT then and let him have it in his pocket. But I do a DBT and then you just deduct it from there. It's a DBT for something else and you're deducting the loans from something else. I think some kind of system would have to be evolved whereby at least you talk to him and tell him why you're taking this and what you're taking it from. You can't take his subsidy away just like that. He needs to be informed. Then we've talked about these credit deposits. Lending to priority sectors, and especially the agriculture sector, I think really needs to improve. There are big gaps. That's why I'm saying it's very important that the district sits with the banks, with the lead banks. And at a point in time, if you ask for this, and you can engineer it whichever way you want to, but that information doesn't come in the SMPC meeting. So you need to do it. 33 districts get reviewed in, let's say, 4 months of SMPC. So every year, if they get reviewed, then we all know where we are and we all know where we need to go. Just giving you an example. If the laggard district starts to match the good performer districts, then the trajectory of growth becomes much, much higher. And that's the reason, that's where we have to look. So I'm saying, I'm giving an example of priority in agriculture sector lending in Bundi and Bara, for example.